Hello everyone, and welcome to our very last topic for this semester in personal development, which is the career and pathways. Alright, so we are nearing at the end of this subject, and the main goal of personal development is for you to know yourself better, for you to be able to choose a career that you want to pursue in life. So at the very beginning of this subject, the main goal is for you to know yourself, for you to be able to decide what you really want to pursue in the future. So, mo ani ang tumong jud sa personal development. Deciding what you want to pursue in life is very hard. In fact, even personally, me, I still have confusions on what I really want in life. So, munang deciding what you want to pursue in life is very hard. You have to know what you like, your hobbies, your environment, and even yourself. Understanding what you want is not an easy step, and a whole semester is not enough for you to decide at the end. But hopefully, at the end of this semester, hopefully, you were able to have some clarity on what you really want in life. So, muna itong hisgutan karon, the career and pathways. So, in making your career plan, it is important to know and understand the key factors that influence your career options. So, these are your internal and external factors, your life goals, your personal core values, your strengths and challenges, your personality traits, and your characteristics and passion. So, mo niya nga tong tanawon, or mo niya nga tong kitaon, if we are going to plan for our career. So, kinahanglan ato jud ning tanawon ug sabton ang kani sila tanan, which is the internal external factor, your life goal, your personal core values, your strength and challenges, your personality traits and characteristics, and your passion. Unsa man jud ni sila. For you to be able to know what you really want in life. So it is also important to know and understand the different occupations and the skills and interests necessary to fit in the job. That is also very important. Okay, so now we are going to talk about the external factors that may affect a Filipino adolescent's career choices. First external factor is the parental preferences. So, parents dictating what course their child will make. Nakanira na, pag maestra na kay kuan, maestra imong imong ante, maestra imong uncle, dato na sila, daghan na sila kwarta, na sila sakyanan, kay maestra, and so on and so forth. So, parental preferences. Kinahanglan, magpulis ka, kay ako pulis, imong papa pulis, imong uncle pulis, imong tatay pulis, imong lolo pulis, daghang pulis sa family. Or even, kanira ang kuha anak, kay mo na yung gusto para ni mo. That is the parental preferences, which is very common, diba? Nga makahinder sa ato, nga sa atong gusto dyan nga kuhaon. Second one is the family considerations. Other siblings might be priority in terms of college education. So sometimes, namalagi tayong mga igsoon, and sometimes, dili man makaya financially, mo na nga ipalabon sa laman ang igsoon. That's why, maingon si mama, si papa, nga, nak, pahom nun sa laman atong skwela, ay mo igsoon. Ikaw man sa mo igsoon, ikaw na pod. So, ma-stop na ka. So, that is an external factor. Then we have the financial constraints. So, real and often common factor when selecting a career. Ma'am, ganahan dyan ko mag-med, ma'am. Unja kay di man dyan kaya sa ang family. Kay si papa, motorcab driver. Si mama, mamaligyag sudaan. Pero ganahan dyan ko mag-med, ma'am. So, unsaon man na to? Financially, we are unstable. Maybe, you if maybe you can pursue that kung mag-scholar ka. But still, naghihapon ang mga gasto, ang pagpuyo, ang kaon. Sus, kadaghan, gadyong kaon palang daan, ang weekly allowance. So, kinahanglan dyan ni mong i-considerate financially mo na nga, di nalaman ka mag-med, ngita nalaman kaglain, na kaya ni mama o ni papa, diba? Then we have the job market demand and supply. A course that can offer immediate employment is often chosen over a preferred course for practicality purposes. So, nani daghan. Unsa may demand karon nga job? Nursing. Oh, demand ang nursing karon. Will it be demand after 20 years? Or after, let's say, for example, 5 years? Will it be demand after 5 years after you graduated? Okay, grade 12, then first year, second year, third year, 4 years, so 5 years. After 5 years, will nursing be still in demand? Makatrabaho ba ko ako dayon kung maoni akong kuhaon? Or teacher? Mag-teacher ko ma'am kay demand si Jaka Adjo. Is it really demand after 5 years? Kung mahuman ka ana, ma-demand pa ba ka ana si Jan na job? If yes, then you can pursue it. So, unsa man di ay ang gitalk about aning job market demands. So, we have to see the reality. Unsa may mga kurso ko noong dili maningon nga dili magamit, but not reality check. Dili si ja practical. So what are these courses? Unsa man? Let's have the fine arts. Maybe if you have the money, then you took the fine arts, then that would be fit for you. But if you are struggling in life financially and you took fine arts, after fine arts, what are you going to do about it? So, adyo ko inang mahog ka sa lain nga career. Mahog ka nga magtindera na laman. Kay waka kay bagun sa imong buhaton or asa ka musod. Because fine arts are for those people nga passionate about arts. And they find art as something that they can pursue in life. Manggod. So, it's dili si dya ingon practical nga course. But many, of course, many people are already studying fine arts. Madyo laman lagi kung magamit siya na nimo or makakita siya kagtrabaho, ana. So, job market, demand, and supply. So, you have to balance that. Then, we have the school location. So, chosen course may not be offered in a school near one's residence. So, ma'am, di man jud kinahanglan, murag di man jud naho kaya nga ato sa Cebu. So, dali ra jud ko sa Maasin. Tsaka may medtech diri sa Maasin, ma'am. Tsaka nahan man ko mag-medtech. So, no choice. Career shift. Sige. Gusto dyan ko mag-medtech, pero wak man lagi. Nursing, nalaman ko, ma'am. Diba? So, because of school location. Sometimes, kaya di kaganahan mo larga o laing lugar, you still want to be with your family, and you still want to be near them, mo na nga na-factor sa dyan ang school location. Then, we have the peer pressure. Friends going to another school, or a course where they can still be together is often an issue for adolescents. Mag-unsa man kabay, mag-pulis ko. Sige, mag-pulis na lamang po ko para na ako'y kauban. So, mao na. Peer pressure. Sometimes, wala kagi pressure by your peers. But you yourself, na-pressure kanila. Okay. So, sometimes, the decisions of your peers can sometimes affect your decisions in life. Tungod kay tanan ni mong barkada at mong Cebu, so ikaw ato na lang mong Cebu. So, like that. Then we have the gender bias. There are some careers that are gender biased and may even carry an unpleasant stigma. Let's say, for example, mo nang education or teacher. Ay, pambadji raman good ng teacher. O, diba? So, na'y gender bias. Mayingon ka nga, di ka pwede kay pambadji raman ng teacher, which is not true. Or welding. Ganaan pa siya mag-welding, ma'am. Diyan ay panglaki raman ng welding, di ka pwede na panglaki raman, which is gender bias. So, ana. Then we have the language limitation. Not so much of a concern if one's career choice is available locally, but may become a problem if it's available somewhere else. Let's say, for example, you want to go to UP, Tacloban. Gusto ko ka mag-UP, but waray, kinahanglan ka mag-waray. So, there is a language gap there. Okay, then we have the academic performance. One's academic standing in high school is a major factor in the choice of college course. So, this happened to me. So, Jud, the academic performance. Now, to tell you honestly, I am not that good in high school. I mean, I don't study. I have very low grades. So low. Like, teach ko magtuon. And I always skip school. Like, the typical nga siaw. And because of that, I got low grades. So, 84, na 83, 80, somewhere na lang, mga grado, 76, 75 sometimes. So, when I reached the college, I went to Visayas State University because I want to pursue physical education, which is my dream course. No, not my dream course, but my very first option. Modyo na yung gusto nga ma-pursue. Kung dili man ako ma-pursue ang akong dream course, which is psychology, then shift ko to physical education. But when I went to Visayas State University, tanaw ko sa imong card, ay, pak! My average was 84.5 or 84.50, and the passing average is 85. So I was very frustrated, and I was like, ngano wa mo nagtarong, ngano maning, ngano man ang grado. And that was the biggest crisis in my life. Kaya wadyo ko kay bawag, asan ako pa dong. And so I took up another one, which is I didn't intend, and I didn't love, and I didn't even know. So I took up BS Economics, and that was the biggest mistake of my life, because why would I took economics? I even hate math, and I don't even know math, and just simple college algebra, di ka ni ko katigo, then why did I choose economics? So, kabe ang akong crisis ato nga time. Because of the academic performance nga, wa na-achieve ang akong gusto. So, mo na nga ka mo, you still have grade 12. So, I know, moingon mo nga, grades doesn't matter, but it really matter sa gusto ninyo nga kurso. It will really matter. Alright, so let's move on to the internal factors that may affect one's choice of career. Number one is the personal core values. So, in planning a career, requires the students to go through some soul searching and an understanding of who they are and what they are made of. So, kinahanglan mag soul searching jud ta kung we're going to choose a career. Unsa gyud ang ato? So kinahanglan ato sa nang unahon ug maadyo. So one internal factor that can affect your choice is your personal core value. Go through the exercise in identifying one's personal core value. So unsa man day imong mga values in life, your personal. So remember that this is all about you. So unsa man, then your passions. So these are questions to answer to identify one's passion. What are you passionate about? Mom, I'm very passionate about plants. I really love plants, and I can name the scientific names of the different cactuses and the different succulents and the different plants and the whatever. Then you can be a botanist. Oh, so nanas viska. You can be you can take the course agriculture because you really love plants and you know them. But diba? What are you passionate about, ma'am? Ganahan siya kung mag-bike-bike, ma'am. As in, like, bike is life. Oh, so unsa man. Oh, maybe you engage in sport wherein you go triathlon. Oh, kay aron ma, ko anak ka, mo abot makagawas, mo sige lang triathlon, sige lang bike-bike. What are your passions in life? And that is a factor nga imong i-consider in choosing your career. Then we have the personality traits. The personality trait is the traits are most compatible with what kind of careers. Oh, so if you have undergone the INCAI, or the INCAI result, wherein sometimes po naapoy result ito kung unsay fit nimo na course, di ba? And sa guidance pod office, na po yung mga personality exams that can determine on asa mo fit ang imong personality sa mga jobs. So, if you want to know about that, you can go to our guidance counselors. Then we have the strength and challenges. So, knowing oneself is important in selecting a career path. So, you have to know your strength and you have to know your challenges in life. So, what are your strengths and your weaknesses? Then, we have the personal limitations. Personal limitations is the reality of one's limitation can bite. Asa raman ka kutob? Ma'am, gusto ko mag-law. Gusto ko ma-attorney. Pero, makasabot kong sentence, ma'am. Pero kung daghan ng sentence ina ko kasabot, ma'am. Right? So, there is a personal limitation. Imong kaugalingon. Sometimes, yung ka nga, I want to take up law, ma'am, but I am not that intelligent. I can't decipher kanang very taas ng mga case or mga kaso din ako ana kasabot. So there is the personal limitation. Then we have the sixth one is the life goals. So craft your life goals based on your personal core values. Unsa man day mong mga goals in life? I want to be a billionaire, ma'am. Okay, sige. You want to be a billionaire, then what will you do? I will invest my talent. Sige, what is your talent? TikToking. Sige, go. Then TikTok and invest in dancing and whatever you do, post it in social media, became famous and you will become billionaire one day. O, diba? That is your goals in life. Right? So, those are the internal factors that can affect one's choice of career. So, looking at the priorities in the job market is also important. So, you have to look for what is very demand. Unsa may kinahanglan sa atong job market? Kinahanglan engineer? Kinahanglan kay daghang tulay nga himuon nun. Daghang dan nga gubunon nun. Tapakan na pod. O, diba? Is nursing on demand? Yes, very in demand. Ganun man. Daghang masakiton. Daghang masakiton. Daghang kinahanglan ayuhon. Diba? In demand ba, ma'am, ang IT? Yes, it is in demand. Ngano in demand man ang IT, ma'am? Because as the years pass by, technology also updated. So, mo-update na po ang technology, makinahanglan na po na silang mga IT experts. Diba? So, as this is an indicator, so the job market is an indicator of how you will be absorbed and provided with employment. So, make sure that at the end of your schooling, your four-year course in college, you will be employed. Not necessarily na agad-agad, after graduate, employed ayon, not necessarily, but as much as possible, magamit ni mo ang imong gi-eskwelahan. Kaya na may uban good nga, yes, nag-skwela sila o teacher, naman nila ang teacher, pero nahugra sila o lain nga career. Let's say, for example, nag-call center. Nya, call center ragajud ang ila through the end, throughout the life that he or she have. So, sayang ang imong iskwilahan. Okay? So, however, there are other factors that you have to consider when thinking about the job market, priorities or preferences. And these are your plans. So, what are your plans 5 years from now? Or what are your plans 10 years from now? Pamplano dyan na ako, ma'am, nga mularga ko gawas. Okay, so, plano man dyan na nimo nga mularga ka gawas, what is the course nga dali ka makalarga o gawas? Mag-HRM siguro ko, ma'am. Kaya ron, dali ra ko makagawas. Or, mag-culinary baka ko, ma'am. Or, mag-bartending. Or, unsa pa na di ha? Mag-cruise ship, mag-seaman. Anong mga ito nga kagawas? So, muna yung buhaton, ma'am. Kaya mularga mo dyan kagawas. Muna nga, you have to choose a course that is fit for your plans in life. Muna, very important dyan nga na kay plano. Kay even me, up until now, I'm still planning for my future. Of course, we are always planning for our future. But what I mean is, I'm still planning for what am I going to do? Am I going to pursue the teaching career forever? Or am I going to switch career? So struggle pa na nahoron because I don't plan ahead. So mo na, that's a problem of it. If you don't plan ahead, so at the end of the day, mag-struggle ka kung unsa man jud ay imong plano in life. Diba? But anyways, always remember that careers can change because your life circumstances also change. So personal core values can shift according to your need. That is why there is a need to undertake values clarification every now and then. So munang magsigidyo kag think or magsigidyo kag ask sa imong mga core values or imong mga needs in life. Okay, mag-change mangadyo na ang imong, especially at your stage right now. So you are still confused on what you want to pursue. So mauna sa siya. Right? So good luck in choosing your career. May this subject help you in deciding what you really want to pursue in life. So I am very hopeful to see you next semester. Hopefully face to face. Pero kung dili pa, then stay safe. So, that is our very last lesson in personal development. And I hope that this semester has reached you to the point in deciding what you want to pursue in your life. So, I want you to answer the activity provided and do the performance task that I will be giving you in our page. Okay? So, thank you so much for listening. And goodbye.